Look at you, you're not even hiding with your head the other way. You are feeling better, buddy. Yeah.
He really likes these, don't you?
So the lady that came,
I don't remember what day she came through here, but I had done a meet and greet. She had two little dogs and she met Thunder. She wanted to foster him. I told her he was going to be a good idea, and then he was way too interested in the foster. Or the little dog, female. And so she emailed me last night about him, and I said, bring him down and we'll see, you know, how he does. I said, I think he might be fine, but keep in mind that he's been hurting for a while, and it's kind of hard to get him. No, that's actually a breed. I thought that was bullshit. I don't know if that's real, but there are actually rabbits.
Oh, no.
That looks fake with what he's doing right there, but... No, there actually is a breed of rabbits, because we talked about this during COVID when we had our 12-hour days. We talked about all kinds of weird shit back. And somebody, we talked about something like this.
Well, that was thing.
Yeah, so during the height of COVID, we had to split every single team into two. So we did, one team was there Sunday, Monday, Tuesday for 12 hours each day, and then 4 hours on Wednesday. And then our B team came in on the second half of Wednesdays. So there was like either 2 or 4 hours, and I think it's 4 hours in between us. So they had to clean everything top to bottom before they left. That was the last thing they did on Wednesday, and then they all went home. And then when we came in, it was like 4 hours later. And then we were there for the 4 hours on Wednesday, and then Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So Saturday night, that was our beat clean. So then they came back in on Sunday. Oh, every week, you don't even know. But we have 3 12-hour days, which was really rough. But there weren't customers coming in for a solid 12 hours, so we would have a chunk of time, like at the end of the night, we'd all be in the lobby cleaning everything top to bottom, and we'd talk about all kinds of weird shit. Just every night. And that was one that somebody said, did you ever see, because Kaylee Rain has this fear of rabbits. And somebody said, did you ever see those giant rabbits? And I went, that's not a real thing. And then we stopped what we were doing. Here we are in the middle of the pack lobby, and we're Googling stuff, and we're like, that's not real. And then somebody else gets their phone, and we're like, crap, it actually is. They are, I don't think that is, but they are a thing.
The jackrabbits, they're bigger than my dog. They're huge.
Yeah. Why is this upside down? Did you do this on purpose?
What?
Oh, I bet that fell.
Oh, yeah.
Where was it?
It was just, I'm just.
Oh, sorry.
We have
the same
problem. And I'm
yeah, it's just that first little bit in the morning. Well, no, because yesterday we had Rick and Judy from Fridays came in, and they were here until about noon, and they said it was great because it helped us get over that initial hump. And then as the afternoon progresses, they're pretty quiet and they're sleeping.
I'm this far out, I might as well go to Tucson Mall. You could have caused me money.
You told that in the
I did.
So fairness, whatever money you spend from this point on, that's tomorrow when I was getting done. I'll take care of one shoulder of the whole thing.
I'll take you by the bun.
Yeah, and then bonding.
What would you like?
Yale collar. It's so much
easier. Those pickles are good.
Yeah, I'm leaving.
I've had enough. It's been a long week.
Kind of the next step down as a training device after you leave. So we're going to see if it fits.
Let's see if we can do this without breaking it.
Like holes. And as a matter of fact, I won't have to order it because Bonnie will sell me one.
I'll go in with you.
See, this is where it works for Sophia because she's.
Damn it. All right. Mm-hmm. My butt? Oh, but I have. Would you like one of these? Oh.
Oh.
How's the shoe?
Huh?
You're standing. No, Nick.
Oh, it pushed in.
That's it, we're done. You're gonna go right there and it's gonna look cute and that's where it's gonna stay.
And then I did that. I'm making more of a mess than I'm fixing.
Grab hold of it.
Might just be a tequila day for Bonnie.
No, I'm not drinking that cheap shit, though.
I've had enough bad hangovers from cheap tequila.
Remember when they used to do dollar tequila shots?
Worst hangovers ever from that stuff.
Just the word tequila makes my stomach kind of.
Yeah, that mine too.
I just the word.
So I had a buddy of mine years ago who, where at, what bar was it? Somebody, someplace downtown.
Sit.
And he's like, let me buy you some tequila. I'm like, yeah, no, I'm not in the mood. He's like, what do you mean? No. So he orders them anyway. Right, because that's what he wanted. So he orders them, and the bartender brings them over and says, "Thanks again." And he said, "No, no. Where's the salt and where's the lime?" He's like, the guy looks at me and he looks at his friend, and he just shakes his head and rolls his eyes and walks away.
Thank you. Oh, good boy.
He goes, I said, no, no. I said, tequila is. That's what you do.
Wow.
And he's like.
Like a sexual thing to me. I'm doing a paper Michael left before me. I'll be back in a minute.
Oh.
So now, why didn't you offend anybody? The Thursday people could tolerate me.
Oh, okay. Oh, believe me, the Sunday crew.
I heard it's a good group.
Yeah. And it's actually pretty tame today.
Yeah, well, you know why? Because Ellie's
there. Yeah, it's all Ellie.
It is.
Oh, it's Ellie.
You know, it's her 21st birthday today.
I do.
It's your 21st
birthday?
Yes.
Oh, my God. She's like, yeah, my parents are coming down. I'm like, yeah, that's not what I asked for.
Well, they want to
I can't either. I don't even want to be back here.
No, I don't want to be back here. I don't want to be back here. Decision. Because when it's ready to bolt
Yeah, that was a nasty, nasty day at work, let me tell you. And my boss comes out, she was so mad at me. I'm coming in for you, bud. Okay, comes out. Oh my, are you so happy I'm growing? I think you are. Okay, get up there. Are you gonna get up there again? No? No? Okay. I can't hear you. Fuck, come over. In front of me, still drunk.
Probably not wrong about that.
Whoa.
Oh, I have a rough night. Wait, you just wait there, I have to get some bags. You stay. Okay. Now we're ready. Now we're ready.
Oh, that is on. Yeah.
Did you see that one?
The other one, yeah.
Yeah, and another one just.
I think it has happened before. Good boy.
What are you doing? We call you trouble.
Is Dawn in here?
Yeah, she's sitting with Killer over here.
Oh, okay. It's so quiet, I guess she's not walking.
A little rascal.
Did you hear what she said?
What?
It's so quiet in here, she didn't think you were in here. That's what I heard.
Okay. You know what? Okay, you guys are in for it. Okay, what are we talking about now? Okay, let me get on the subject.
That's a good kid, I like that, sit down, stop.
Does Lauren have a cell name?
Yeah, it's not him. I did the same thing. It totally looks like they could be related, don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are they
that's his family. No. Weird, yeah?
Oh. You miss her, huh? Did she come up with you?
Oh, no. His number is 806-873 in person. It's 823-099. They're not even close. Chest is straight on the head. I mean, his is much narrower than hers, but.
You got one
jet
that.
Yeah, I was going to say, make
sure you're
right on.
So, Steve, we were talking about this yesterday, actually, and Steve said, because he asked me about Antonio.
Yeah.
And so I told him the story and then the side story of Regina.
Uh-huh.
And I said, so here's the funny thing. Had Jet not screwed up, because she saw Antonio on our Facebook page, not on Praxis' stuff.
Okay.
She said it was his pictures and her story that got me,
uh-huh.
And that brought me in here. Well, first time just had Chris came with her, and that's how he ended up taking Gina home.
Okay.
So, had Jeff not pulled the wrong door off the weekend before, when I realized it was Sapphire's kennel, even after Sapphire went to foster, he was a medical dog, so even though he was just a baby at only 13 months old, I kept bringing him up because he had a jacked up foot. So had they not accidentally sent him up, he would never have been on my radar because I don't look at dogs that young that are medical dogs because I have a reason for them to. So it was all just a total fluke that he ended up here in the first place and then continued coming up.
Mm.
And then because her kennel was right there, like, so I got two dogs out that, you know, might have still both been, because they were both black, you know, he was a medical, like, significant medical. And she was a black kitty one day. He's such a great dog. He's Striker's got so much potential.
I mean, this dog yesterday, I literally opened his mouth, dropped the trouser on, clamped it shut, and he left.
Who's that?
Striker, I did it again this morning, yeah, I did it again this morning. Let me, both times, let me put the harness on, it was no problem. Yeah. Which is a big deal for me,